with the face. Glad you're here. And today we're going to do something with something I actually found. And if you check out the flea market, there's a couple of tubs there too. This one is called It's a Wonderful Shave. Now, years ago, I brought this into existence for Wet the Face. It did very well. But, you know, like all soaps, I had to put it in the vault for a while, and I haven't taken it out at all. But there are a couple of tubs up there. I just found this. And it has a really, really pleasant Christmas smell. So I'm going to use this. I'm going to use the Wet the Face brush. And let's see if I can pick out maybe the Occam's Razor Nano, or maybe just the regular Occam's Razor. Don't know yet, but we're gonna use one of those, and then we're gonna make a lather. We're gonna put it in a bowl, and make a lather, bring it to the face. But I want to also talk to you about something else. So. I touched a little bit about what Chuck and I are working on, and I want to show you the prototype of this. It's our travel case. It's a travel kit. That's what we call it. Now, these are supposed to be black, but, we're working on getting them to fit correctly because you have to, it's a trial and error thing. So, we want to make sure that it's functional when we go to print it for everybody if they want one. I'm taking them off now. I don't have, there's a metal piece that goes in here that holds the two top and the bottom together, but I don't have it correct yet. So I'm just gonna open this up and let you see what it looks like. So on the bottom here, and I'll just take the top off. On the bottom here is, you can put, let me just get like an, you could take a, let's see, it's tilted this way. So, you see, it has a place for an aftershave. It has a place for a shaving soap and the razor and you could put like, septic pencils in there, anything you want. This, I believe, is for the like a pack of razors. It's what you're gonna need if you go on a trip and you don't want to put it in like a case, like one of those flimsy cases, and you want to protect everything. This will definitely do that. This will protect everything. So. That's our thing that we're working on. And there's no rush on this because we want to make it right. So we print it. He does little tinkering. I print it, we look at it. I'll be sending him this prototype. I think he needs to actually see it so he can hold it in his hand, you know? Me telling him what things are is not as good as him holding it in his hand and really, really understanding what's going on. So that's that. I just wanted to bring that to your attention. So don't go away. We'll be right back. So you can see that the bowl is empty, right? And this is the soap that we're gonna be using today. It's called It's a Wonderful Shave. And the soap is still pliable, and I'm gonna just spread it around in there. Take some more. Okay. I'm going to just place that down there. Now, here's the Wet the Face brush, which I'm going to just drench with warm water. I'm gonna empty the contents of the brush right there. So let's let's incorporate all that soap, making sure that the brush touches everywhere I placed it, and then we'll start going. And the scent is still strong after all those years. It's still going. You gotta hand it to shaving soap. It's resilient, that's for sure. Wow, I got plenty here. All right, so let's bring this to the face and do the shave. So I have about 6 or 7 days growth, so let me with the face. And I'll tell you, it's Monday today. I usually shave on a Sunday and then do all the edits and stuff and then release it on a Saturday. I didn't feel like doing anything because I wanted to stay home an extra day after Thanksgiving because I was supposed to have my mailbox installed, but the guy never showed up. Nice, right? Let me install this. Let me apply this to the face. Yeah, you know. I guess it's typical with contractors, you know, they tell you they're going to be there and then something happens. So, I mean, it's been going on for 2 weeks with this guy. I tell him, I'm going to take off Monday. Okay. And then I get a text from the guy almost at the end of the day, you know, like 4:30. Oh, like, are you home Tuesday? No, dude. What a duty head. Anyway, story of my life. Shit happens. All right, there you go. Okay, I'm just wetting, I decided on the rose-colored Nano. It's the first one in the series, and let me just start down here. This is a little heavier than the original, than the Nano. They hollowed out the handle for the Nano and made some other improvements, like getting under the nose. That was a problem. And it is a lot easier with the enhanced Nano than the one I have here. I took a look at Prime videos, and I've been neglecting that service. Of course, they give it to you because you're paying for, you know, the Prime service and in the delivery. But there's so much on Netflix that I just neglected to look. And there's been some things I wanted to see. So I have it all marked off. And I'll be talking about those things as soon as... as soon as I'm done. I did see something. It was in the vein of Harry Potter. It was something called the something door. I can't remember now. It's about a door that this guy had to find. It was hidden. And he had the abilities to find it. But I'll let you look at it. I mean, it's like a magical place, it seems like. And he found it, but I won't spoil it for you. I'll put the name of it, the actual name, somewhere as I'm talking here, because I just forgot. I know it's something door. All right. And it's only on Prime, so. Okay. All right. So what I'm gonna do is, I have an old pencil that I'm gonna be using right now, because I took my Allen block and I put it in the kit to see if it would fit. And everything fit, but I left it out there in my office. And this is a real old pencil that I'm using. And right after I'm done doing this, I probably will throw this away, because it's just, you know, it's too old. It's crumbling, you know. But it's doing the job. Stopping any bleeding. Very, very good. Very good. Let's listen. I just threw it away. Yeah. Everything's got to go. So, I don't have any aftershave that's going to match that, but let me just see. Nah, it's just not going to match it. You know what? Maybe I'll just put a little of my modern barbershop on. It won't match the Christmas, but I like the scent of this. It still goes well. Okay. So I had a great shave. And I hope you guys have a great shave too. And we're heading towards Christmas. So get all your stuff. Because it comes up as soon, really, really quick. It just, for me anyway, that's what happens. I lose all track of time, and then all of a sudden it's like the last minute. So like I said, I had a great shave. Hope you have one too. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.